all of our, thank you, Hannah, all of our partner schools that use LiveSchool get up and running, make sure their questions get answered, make sure that we share tips and tricks and best practices, and just anything that people are wondering, we try to make sure that they get that answered. And I'm joined by some amazing educators from DCPS who are here to share a little bit more about themselves and their stories, but I will let them introduce themselves. So Desiree, if you wouldn't mind just kind of sharing a little bit about how you got to where you are today.
Okay, yeah. So, hi guys. My name is Desiree Caldwell. I teach high school English at McKinley Tech Education Campus, where I have proudly taught for 16 years. And we got introduced to LiveSchool this past year, and I just really loved it. And I'm so excited to share more about how we use it and what it looks like at McKinley.
Yeah. Wow, 16 years is amazing.
Yeah.
Ryan, if I could get over to you, share a little bit about yourself.
Sorry. Hello, everyone. My name is Ryan Sturdivant. I'm Dean of Students at McKinley Technology High School. I myself have been a part of McKinley Tech for some time. I was a former student. I graduated in 2013, so it was a quick return. Now as Dean of Students. So, introducing Live School this year has been really exciting, and I can't wait to share our experience with you guys.
Oh, I just love that you have so much love for the school community that you were once a part of, that you're back to serve it as an administrator. This is amazing. And then finally, Tony, if you could give us a quick intro as to who you are and how you got here.
So I'm Tony. I teach environment and biology at McKinley Tech. This is actually the third school I've seen LiveSchool rolled out at. So I worked with it at Kelly Miller in DC and at KIPP down in San Antonio.
Yeah, so much expertise. Well, this is amazing. I hope that all of you attendees are as excited as we are to hear their stories in action. And a couple of quick housekeeping items specifically to address your question, Ray, and probably what we're all wondering. So we are going to record this session and send out a copy afterwards. So if you get pulled away into another meeting or an emergency pops up, feel free to take care of that and know that we'll grab all of that great learning and share that out with you and with everyone that has signed up. So if you've got a colleague that you want to share that with, or you know that they wanted to be here but something came up, know that that will be shared with them as well. And we'll also send out these slides in a follow-up so that you can learn and pull and beg, borrow, and steal from some experts in this area on what they've done to really cultivate that positive school culture and be able to use it in your own school as well. You're probably wondering what it is that we're going to dive into. So specifically, we are going to start by talking through how educators actually provide points in LiveSchool. So if this is your very first interaction with LiveSchool, I'm going to give you just a quick overview of what it looks like. And then we're going to have our amazing DCPS school partners share their stories. So Desiree, Tony, and Ryan, all at McKinley Tech, are going to share how they've put LiveSchool in place. And we're planning on taking about 35 minutes, but leaving 10 solid minutes at the end to go over all of your questions and answers. So make sure that you use that chat to be able to ask any questions that you have. Hannah from our team will absolutely be making sure that all of your questions get answered. And if there are any that are particularly tricky or want to involve some discussion, then she'll be able to ask all of our panelists those as we get to that Q&A section. So, what is LiveSchool? If you're brand new to this, let's start at the top with how our educators, our partners, use LiveSchool to recognize and reward student behavior. And that really starts with the fact that a lot of times our teachers are expected to come up with their own classroom management systems all alone on their own. And we know how exhausting and kind of siloing that can be. So, with LiveSchool, as a school, you set up a consistent school-wide rubric, which allows all of your teachers to align their expectations and encourages very uniform behavior standards across all the classrooms. We're hoping that helps so that no teacher feels like they're trying to do this alone. They're using the same language and the same system as all of their fellow teachers. And then with that school-wide rubric in play, all of your staff members can award points across any setting. So they could be in the classroom, the cafeteria, the hallway, the bus, wherever that makes sense, you can use any device to give that instant reinforcement to all of your students that they have demonstrated the positive behaviors that are in your rubric. And then you as a team get to use all of that real-time data to enable you to make better supportive decisions on behalf of your students. So you can start understanding their behavioral patterns. You could, for example, if you're a last period teacher, you could now see all of your students' daily interactions, both positive and corrective, with all of their teachers. And so then you can make a decision about how you want to approach them and that last period class. But to get to the real story of Live School, I'm going to turn it over to Ryan and Desiree and Tony, and they're going to dive into how McKinley Tech is specifically using Live School with their high school students. And we're going to start at the top with Ryan. If you could share a little bit about how it is that you've come to make sure that teachers are really bought into having that school-wide system.
Thank you, Laura. With Live School, you know, it was a really something very different that we introduced to McKinley Tech this year, with us being a high school, coming in with a PBIS system such as Live School. We thought that it was a great way to encourage our students and to build up our school culture. So one way of encouraging the teacher buy-in is by acknowledging the rewards and their efforts. You know, constantly communicating with the teachers and staff about how the rewards can affect our student culture and could affect our students in a positive manner, with wanting them to participate in certain things and earn these points for different reasons. Secondly, it's very important to provide the training and the support to the teachers and staff. As you will see, it's a lot different for some teachers when they're first getting into working with a system such as Live School. Not many are used to working with a PBIS system, specifically on a high school level. So it's really important that you provide that training and that support throughout the school year. Third, foster the collaboration. So I have Mr. Gross and Ms. Caldwell here, who are both, they were gems this year with helping me, myself and Dean, and another Dean Kane, at McKinley Tech with implementing Live School. It wasn't easy, but having these guys to help us, just coming together and creating somewhat of a Live School team, we were able to really roll out Live School and be successful this year. And lastly, and certainly not least, clear communication. It's so important to communicate about Live School throughout the year. One thing that we saw heading in back from Christmas break was that, you know, there was a dip in how many points were given out and things of that nature. So it's really important to get on top of it and just communicate with your teachers and staff throughout the year. Some may think you're becoming a little pest about it, but it's about continuing that communication and building that school culture. And it all starts with the communication.
Yeah. Well, and you know, after Ryan and his team, so both deans were really getting Live School up and running. I know that there were a lot of pieces of making this personal to McKinley Tech that Desiree, you were specifically diving into and making sure that this felt like something that teachers were doing together. Do you want to speak more to kind of how did you really make it something that was your own?
Yeah. So like, you know, from the teacher's perspective, you go to in-service week, you're learning all the new changes for the school year, and it's just so exhausting and intimidating. And Live School is one of them. And I was like, oh, this is awesome. Because I love this kind of stuff. You know, it really worked well in my classroom management approach. And so by the end of like the first month, you know, Tony and I had given out the most Live School points in the whole school. And we kind of got together to be like, like, how can we encourage more of our teachers to love it as much as we do, like our colleagues? And so I was like, I asked him, I was like, do you want to do like a committee and just get people together to kind of say, okay, this is a cool program, but what's it going to look like at McKinley? Because Live School is not a one size fits all. You have so many different ways to set parameters. You get to define what you're like supporting kids in and rewarding them. And there's so many different like nuances to make it your own. So like, what would it look like for McKinley? So we sent out a staff and we got a team of like five teachers together who were like, yeah, let's like norm this out. And so some of the norms that I wanted to highlight from that work that we did as a committee was, we wanted to reward students. We believe that rewarding students for what they do right is equally, if not more important than penalizing them when they do wrong, okay? We wanna make sure that we build a culture of success and celebration in the classroom, because that's what's gonna cultivate the environment that problem behaviors just less likely to occur in the first place, you know, preventing that problem behavior in the first place. And then we wanted to build an entire school culture where everyone felt connected, to kind of talk about like student success requires teacher buy-in as well. It has to be a whole school approach to this manner. It can't just be a couple teachers. It's not going to work, right? Like a PBIS system is not going to work if just a small group of teachers are doing it. So we got together as a committee. Shout out to Mr. Gross for co-leading that committee. And we were able to kind of define the parameters and measures that we thought were going to encourage the most teacher buy-in, get the most success for our kids. And Mr. Gross, you can kind of move forward and tell them more of what that looked like.
Yeah, I think a lot of it is kind of understanding the strengths of your team and the culture you're trying to build for your students. So a lot of it is having conversations about, hey, what are some norms that we want to see across different classrooms? What should students, and I don't want to say like what should students expect, but if there is some consistency in what they're seeing from one place to the next, it really does build on that kind of culture. So having those conversations with other teachers and working with the deans and kind of finding out what are everybody's needs. I thought that was really valuable for our school. So we kind of, as live school is like highly like customizable, you know, it was like, do we want a ton of options that are super specific so we can do it that way? Should we try to whittle it down to things that we want to focus on, like what our values are? And this is like what you're looking at right now is kind of what is what McKinley Tech came up with, where you're seeing our overarching ideas of care, community achievement, respect, and excellence, with a few examples on what each of those core values looks like. So so live school for us is a reflection of the core values of McKinley Tech, and it gives us an opportunity to say like, hey, I'm watching you do X, Y, and Z. Like, hey, you were here on class, or like you were in class on time, you were fully prepared, you had all your work done. So I can give you live school points for like community and achievement, for demonstrating expectations and prepared for class or self-starter, however you would like to do that. But really, it kind of falls back on some of the stuff that all of us as educators have been doing already. A lot of us positively narrate when we see something we really like. So this is just one more kind of emphasis to like, it's you're saying something, and then, you know, as you work with the PBIS system, it does add a small bit of incentive for that as well. So that's how we've been using it here at Tech.
And do you want to speak a little bit to kind of the flexibility that's still allowed in this framework? So I know you had talked about specific instances where people might give points. How are teachers still encouraged to make some decisions about what this will look like in their own classrooms?
Yeah, so I know that it's like you can use it as much or as little as you'd like. So if you just want to make it a part of your SEL opener, where it's like, you know, all like if your big emphasis, hey, is, hey, I want my students here on the bell and I want us to get started immediately, great. Then like a part of your classroom, like setup, a part of your like do now or whatever it may be, could just be, look, when you walk in my door on time and ready to go, you already have an opportunity to earn 3, 5 live school points, however you'd like that to be, right? Now, if you're teaching an AP course and it's really important for you to, for your students to like demonstrate critical thinking skills and like answering higher level questions, then you may want to emphasize more like, I'm going to do a lot of opportunities for my students to earn excellence points for, you know, for going like above and beyond in their academics. So it's kind of like, it's what you want it to be. And it's going to be like, really, it ends up becoming a reflection of what your values are within your classroom. But what's nice is they all interact, like they play nicely with each other. So, yeah.
Yeah. And then I know that as a committee, as a think tank of teachers who are all putting their voice in, you also wanted to lay some sort of expectation or maybe ground rules in place so that there was an economy that was created. Can you kind of speak to either you or Desiree on how you came up with what those point expectations would be and how you shared why we should do this as a staff?
Yeah, I would say like we actually went back and forth a couple times, right? The think tank happened. Well, we rolled it out. I think it was the deans that kind of set the points and we tried it. I think it was like Ryan and Dean Kane, they set the points and we were like, okay, this is, let's go back to the think tank. Let's redesign the points. I think we did that a couple times. It wasn't like a pretty process. It wasn't cut and dry. It was just, but the thought process was that within one day, each kid could earn up to 10 points in a class, four class a day, 40 points. That's where we landed. And then from there, that way there wasn't this sort of metric of like, you had a spectrum of like me, I had thousands of points that I had given. And then you had some teachers that give like one. So that's sort of how we did it.
Yeah. But I think that also really speaks to the fact that this was a growing process that changed with feedback from all of your teachers, that it wasn't something that had to be perfect on the first day. But to your point, you recognize like values you wanted to talk through. Tony came up with examples and kind of tips and tricks for when to give them. And then you kind of settled on what was going to make sense from a economic perspective to put this all together. Any other kind of examples of what teachers have really found to be helpful before we dive into the like rewards aspect or the way that the points are really motivating for students?
Well, I would just say like for me, I love that it's on my phone. So like we have smart boards in our school. I know like due to inequity in the public school systems, not everybody's got smart boards and we need to fix that. But we have smart boards and I can actually log in to my live school and use the randomizer in my classroom to just pick a kid and answer a question and give points live like that. It's so fun. I can walk around in small group with the app on my phone and just give them points and be like, hey, see, I put these live school points in. And it, you know, it's really just like a fun way. And you think high school kids like aren't going to care. They're too cool. Like, no, they really do get into it. Like if you build it, they will come kind of thing, you know, like if you do it consistently, the kids get into it. So I would say like just the flexibility like that and like being able to show it to kids in the classroom is also really cool.
Yeah. And I like, because really all of us, regardless of like whatever your style is, however you teach, whatever age group, you always catch your kids doing something right. And it's really cool when it's like, hey, it like, even if you like students don't always know that you see them doing the right thing. So it's just another opportunity for you to be like, hey, I'm catching you doing this. And, you know, kind of showing a token of your appreciation for that.
Yeah. Well, and lovely to hear that, you know, even high schoolers like that randomizer option of you being able to say, okay, who is going to get that opportunity to, you know, be chosen, and that this works no matter how old you are. I think us as adults on the live school team also use that randomizer for calling each other out sometimes, and it's equally effective for us just to be excited. All right, well, we know that the points that you've been giving and kind of the expectations that you set come to fruition when the points actually lead to rewards and incentives that the students are eligible for. And I know, Ryan, you had a big play in kind of making sure that you had a tiered reward system for the school set up. You want to speak to kind of how you got that up and running and how you made that happen for students and for staff?
Yeah, so we created the reward system by the beginning of the year. We thought of some live school rewards that we will offer to students who earned enough points. And throughout the year, we allow students to use their points to participate. For example, early in the year, we had to wear a Halloween costume, you could spend 25 points. To attend a fall festival, you'll spend 75 points. And over time, you will see that students will be very strategic with their points because they don't want to overspend on an event when they see down the line oh, if I have enough points for this event, then I'll be able to attend this because I saved my last few points. So it could be very helpful with even teaching students how to budget. You know, it's very beneficial, just not just for the classroom or the school. It could be beneficial for them outside of school as well. It's another thing I will mention, it's really important to communicate with students to talk about what type of live school events that they want. Because if they are spending their money, their points on it, it should be something that they want to participate in. And what we found is you'll get a lot more bang for your buck when you do that, because they'll be 10 times on better behavior because they want to earn those points to attend something that they want to attend. So you go to the next slide.
Yeah. And how did you kind of consider what it might look like at the school level versus the class level?
Yeah. So one thing that I love about live school is the creative, how creative we can be with it. I've had times where we've had a situation where a staff member was hosting a pizza party and he asked me, hey, could you add in a pizza party reward for students to go in to select the pizza party to participate in it? This wasn't a school-wide event. This was just for that specific group. And we also encourage teachers to have their own rewards throughout class. Here are some great examples here. Such as homework passes, student of the months, or special field trips. All of these things are things that we can be really creative with in specific classrooms, not only for the school-wide events.
Yeah. And how did you actually kind of decide what it was that would go into your reward store? You mentioned asking the students about the events that would get them excited. But how did you decide to have like purchase a Halloween costume as one of the options available to students?
Yeah. So we really like to base it off of like the different either holidays or whatever break this is coming up. For instance, we had the holiday social. We had a silent party and an ice cream social that was on the same day. So kids had somewhat of an option on which one they wanted to attend. But it's literally us just sitting down, come in a room together, and we're figuring out what type of events we want to put in place. And we try to be strategic over time to plan things in advance so that we could really, really roll out everything and do a lot better with promotion and everything throughout that time, so that students know what they're shooting for with earning their points.
Yeah. Well, and I know, Tony, you had mentioned that you've seen live school in play at multiple schools across different state lines. Can you kind of speak to how have different schools decided what has been important, how they want to focus their efforts? Like, what have those initiatives looked like to implement, you know, school culture changing in different places?
Yes. So about 6 years ago down in Texas, and it was interesting the way they used that. They had set up a really smart economy using both the merit and demerit system, where if you did earn an X amount of demerits, you were actually ineligible to use your merits for like the school store. So they had a budget for that, which was nice. But one of the things that I thought was really smart of them was if they noticed any kind of trends in the demerit side, if it was truancy, if it was like language, whatever it may be for like middle schoolers, they would put an initiative in and they could change the economics of the points and say like, hey, instead of it being 1 point for being on time, now for the next week, you can earn double points for being on time today because that's our big push for our school. So it was a really nice way of like, you can change the value of the points, you can make it flexible. So if you're having an issue with uniforms, you can incentivize that thing that you're looking for students to meet those expectations. So I just thought that was a really smart use of live school, was like change, like tweak, like making really, really small tweaks. And then just kind of like, hey, this is gonna be our push for the month of November. We want our students in time, like on time in uniform, with whatever pencil and paper, whatever your values are, and being able to change the points to kind of like reflect what you want to see in your school culture.
Yeah, I think it's a special sense of flexibility that every school gets to decide exactly what they'd like in their behavior rubric. And so it, even though every single teacher in the school is using the same language, any site leader can go in and make those updates. So to your point, if they're going to have, you know, a bigger push on active listening or participation at any time, a site leader can go in and just say, okay, this should be worth 2 points for the rest of this year or whatever they might want to change it to, so that we can really start focusing on that for the rest of our time. And then all teachers are seeing that and all students are seeing that. Yeah. All right. Well, we've had a lot of great perspectives shared here in terms of what the teachers were thinking through, what the deans were thinking through as they were rolling live school out. But we want to be able to open it up to our lovely attendees and see what additional questions you might have, since you've got some great people to pick brains of. So what kinds of things are you wondering maybe about live school as a whole, or just positive culture systems, how you can enhance the behavior that you're seeing in your students? Maybe you've got a particularly tricky behavior that you're seeing that you're trying to curb now that it's May and everyone can kind of smell the end of school coming around the corner. Yeah, and I'm going to open it up to Hannah to tell us any questions that have been posed in the chat.
Angela just thought of a great one. How often is whole school data reviewed with staff?
Do you mind if I?
Please.
All right. So the answer is it depends on you and it depends on your school. So one of the moves that I saw at a middle school I worked at was making a part of advisory every week. There's an option to print off what they call like paychecks, so students can see all of the positive and negative points that they've earned for whatever period you want to set that for, which is really great, because then they get a sense, like they're checking on it frequently. It becomes a part of the culture. The school I was at was like 5 through 8. And it was a good opportunity to kind of go through and be like, all right, like glows and grows, right? Like, so what's gone well for you in the last week? And like, what are you proud of? And then like, instead of being like, what didn't go, you know, you can ask like, and then like, what might be something we can focus on to get like more points next week, or however you'd like to phrase that. So it's just an opportunity for reflection. And then the staff at that school didn't so much do this, but I do know that a part of the academic leadership team would go through and look at what are the most frequent demerits on, like, they would do that in like as like a bi-weekly data dive. And that was an opportunity for them to see if they could eyeball like what trends they're seeing as far as like like areas of improvement for students.
Yeah.
Awesome. Thank you, Anthony. Erin asked, how can live school contribute to measuring and tracking student wellness?
I think that's an interesting question. I think that when you're positively told you're doing well, it will increase student wellness, right? Like when you are consistently being told, hey, you're doing great. And I think it's also like, you know, what it looks like in the classroom and in the school. So like for us at McKinley, we do student of the month. And all we do is we go to live school, we see who's got the most points, student of the month. And once you've done it, you're out. So I think those are ways too. But, you know, maybe it would even be interesting to kind of make a category to, you know, if a student has done mindfulness like they do in your classroom, right, Mr. Gross? Like you guys practice mindfulness and meditation sometimes, I think. So like, being able to reward students for doing self-care might be something that we might take as a great like tip back to McKinley. Who knows?
It also, I do think this is a great question too. It actually got my brain moving a little bit. When students, every week there's recaps sent out to families. And with that recap, it's talking about all the positive interactions that they've had throughout the week. So that could be a great reminder for the student. And also, if a student is able, they can go into their live school account and also track their progress on their own. So not only those verbal reminders, those reminders when they're going on their live school accounts and looking at their reports, is very important as well.
Yeah, I think that gets at Aaron's latest question that asks, are there any features that allow students to reflect on wellness and belonging? So allowing the students to see the points that they've received through the recap email or in their account. And then I know that some schools like provide specific time every week or couple weeks or month, and encourage students to go in and reflect on those points.
Yeah, are there specific ways that you are currently prompting your high school students to kind of check and see how they're doing, to respond to any, you know, maybe merits that they've received or to make goals for the future about what they'd like to see in terms of their number of points?
The conversations I have with my students are largely about like what, you know, I teach both like freshmen and seniors. So it's a big push for me is like taking ownership over your behavior. So we talk a lot about like, you know, I'll say things like, hey, just so you know, like you guys, like even though there's not a lot of instruction right now, you're clearly like active listening and engaging as a community as we do independent practice. Like, you know, and I talk about the importance of like, hey, because we're meeting these expectations, you've created an environment where everybody gets to be able to focus on their work. So we kind of talk about like why, even if a point is a vague, like even if a point is like a vague description on live school, it's still an important discussion to have as to like what value I put in on it and how you are like showing that value within the class.
And I would bet that especially as students are younger, so if your PK to 5 example, Aaron, that those conversations then also extend beyond just the classroom to what kinds of conversations are our families having with their students. And since we have this school-wide rubric where we can talk about things like active listening, participation, being kind, demonstrating respect. These are big words for our youngest learners. So we need to ask and encourage that our parents have additional conversations with what does this look like when we're at home? What does it look like when we're on the way to school? And then that helps translate into what it looks like when we're in school so we can continue having those conversations beyond just like what Tony and other teachers might be doing with their kiddos, but making sure that we're all using that same language. Yeah. Well, I know we get asked a lot about what kinds of things keep your staff really excited and engaged to giving more points and to seeing, you know, their kids be excited or seeing the students get really amped up. So any tips for teachers who it's May and they're wondering like what would be one way that they could really help drive positive behavior in their classrooms? Anything that you might offer as something that you've tried or something that you're currently in the process of trying?
I think one of the important thing to discuss when it comes to live school or any like, you know, with a lot of PIVA systems is like it isn't an overnight thing. It takes buy-in for like it needs to be consistency across classrooms. So, you know, I think it's always important and I always hear a lot of it is like just, again, using that positive narration as a springboard to use live school, maybe, yeah, and again, like it's May. So like, I'm pretty pumped if I get my kids in the classroom on time. And that's me personally, like that's where I'm at right now with it is like, this is like, I'm starting my class off and live school's up on the board. And like, when you come in, like I'm clicking your name and like, that's how we're starting school. And like, so I do want, you know, and continually just and constantly just let my students know how proud I am of them for being 10 months into the school year and still doing the right thing, like on their own, right? Again, like as a high school teacher, I'm not making my students do anything. They have to make that choice on their own. And I'm always really proud of them when they do. And I try to use live school as a way to show like just a small thing I could give back to them because of how proud I am of them.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would just say, you know, I sometimes it's just on the fly. I'm just like, oh, I'm going to do this. You know, oh, we're doing group work. Oh, let me just, you know, I don't really have any ideas for next year, except now I'm like, how can I do wellness? You know, that's so cool. So yeah, I mean, just rocking and rolling with something I think is great and is working.
And I think both of you capture so well the iterative process of the fact that it doesn't look, this giving points doesn't look the same from the beginning of the year to the end of the year. You focus on different things at different times of the year, but you're constantly making sure to highlight the good choices that your students are making. And so which choice you're focusing on might be different in August versus in May, but you want to make sure that you are, to your point, Tony, positively narrating. Thank you for making that choice. I appreciate it. I'm proud of you. Continue making those good choices. And then to your point, Desiree, there's that room to continue to add on what other choices do I want to be reflecting and recognizing you doing? And so even if McKinley Tech doesn't have a spot on wellness today, it sounds like that think tank is going to come back together and consider what additional elements do we want in our rubric so we can say, you made such a good choice for your own wellness. You used, positive self-talk today. I heard that. It was great. Keep that up, or however you want that to come to fruition in your rubric and however you want to recognize that in your students.
Just to go back real quick, like you had at the beginning of this conversation, talked about how a lot of teachers already have certain types of like incentive systems within their own classrooms, and we're kind of like building it. We were kind of like building it on our own as we went through the school year. So it is super nice that like I was one of those teachers that had my own thing going on, and then live school came around. It was really great to see it much more standardized across different classrooms, using similar language, emphasizing. It was like really like admin and culture would make a lot of decisions on what the emphasis should be, and it was that meant that just like, okay, I can really contribute more to that mission.
And it takes all of you, right, to make it work. I think that's what's so cool about getting to hear the stories from Tony and Ryan and Desiree is it's not just one person. It is the collaborative efforts of both your teacher think tank and your deans that are looking out for what's going to be impactful from a rewards perspective. How can we keep having conversations with students and with other staff members about events that we can offer? What is going to keep those students budgeting their points and wanting to earn more so that they can then attend and participate in those fun activities. And then you get to use that same language across every classroom, whether you're teaching biology or math or science or social, all of those different things to say, like, you're doing a great job. We appreciate it. I'm proud of you. You got one more point towards being able to attend that fun event. Yeah. All right. Well, any other final questions? We're going to open it up to our panelists. If you're got something that's burning and you're not quite sure how to phrase it, or you want to get in touch with us later to be able to ask it, I'm sharing the contact information of all of our amazing panelists today, and we'll include this in our follow-up resources as well. So if you've got the question that you want to pose, but you think of it in 5 minutes from now, feel free to reach out to any of the people here, as well as you can respond to the follow-up email with these resources in there. And if you're wondering, how do we get from where we are to where McKinley Tech is today and all the things that they spoke about, the second to last slide in the deck that we'll be sharing you is going to have all of these great resources that we hope are really helpful around, how we train our teachers, some examples for behavior rubrics, what does it look like to get started with our students, how do we offer our families resources. But more than anything, we just want to say thank you to all of you amazing educators out there. We know that you are always striving for great solutions for your students. If you want to revisit anything, don't forget we'll send out the deck and the recording as a resource. And we cannot wait to see what you accomplish with the rest of your school year, as well as what happens in the fall. Thank you so much to everybody. And thank you so much to panelists for sharing your stories.
Anytime. Take care, guys. Bye.
Thanks, everyone.